WRRS.
WRRS, bring you the latest intermediate school news.
Hello, Intermediate School, and I want to welcome you here to Channel WRRS on November 18th, 2020. I'm Owen Heyer. This station prides itself with bringing you the latest intermediate school news. On this day in 1963, push-button phones are first used, and in 1969, the Apollo 12 astronauts Charles P. Conrad Jr. and Alan L. Bean landed on the lunar surface during the second manned mission to the moon. It is also National Princess Day, National Educational Support Professionals Day. Have you read a good book lately? Ask to rate that book in the library.
Now it's time to rate that book!
Hi, my name is Connor Newland, and I'm in fifth grade. My teacher is Miss Smith, and I like this book called Amulet 8. And I give it a 5 out of 5 because it's a comic book and it has a bunch of cliffhangers that you would have to read the next book out of. So if you're ever bored for a comic book, then this one is a great choice.
So what do you give it, out of 5?
5 out of 5.
Madison, and my ELA teacher is Mrs. Wilbur, and this book is The Searching for a Treehouse, and I'll give it a 5 out of 5 stars because I recommend this book because it's really good, and I love the author, because I read the newest one.
Okay.
The newest one, and it's really good, so I got this one, and it's really good too.
Awesome.
So, yeah.
What is it about?
A treehouse. And they have to finish their story and then give it to their boss or they'll be fired.
Awesome.
And, yeah. And so they're doing a bunch of other stuff on the side and stuff.
So you'd highly recommend?
Yeah.
Awesome.
My name is Charlotte Fetter, and my teacher is Miss Ziganfuss. And I rate this book a 10 because it's by my favorite author, and all her other books are my favorite, and this one.
What is the book?
Ghosts.
Let's find out who this week's student of the week are. Congratulations. It's the third week of the month, so it's time to have a PE video.
And now it's time for physical education.
Thank you.
Thanks, Mrs. Larkin. It's library time with Mrs. Han.
Hello, Intermediate School. The answer to last week's emoji story title is Run, Run, Turkey. And here's a quick glimpse at our next emoji story title. So, we have one person that has four answers correct. So if he gets this week, he will be our winner. So keep watching WRRS and keep submitting those answers. And I can't even believe it. I feel like this is the fastest month ever, but there's no WRRS next week. So I'm going to do the book box draw right now because next week we'll be on Thanksgiving break. So here we go. Blue is for fourth grade. It's Trevor Snyder. Congratulations, Trevor. Come on down and get your prize. I'm going to get a purple for fifth grade. Fifth grade, Brody Mullen. Congrats, Brody. Jasmine Avery for sixth grade. And teacher winner for this month is Miss Well. Congratulations. Come on down and get your prize. I hope you all have a great Thanksgiving. And since we have a few extra days off, maybe before you go on break, stop on down to the library and check out some books so that you can cozy up and read. Have a great one.
Have you checked out a book lately? It's time for a counselor chat.
Mrs. Bailey, back for another counselor's chat. We've been talking about coping skills, so I want to share another coping skill with you. That's one of my favorites. So when you are super upset or angry, your mind does not think clearly. We'll talk about that more in your lessons. Some of you older kids, you might remember the flip your lid lessons me and Mrs. McEnany talk about. But when your lid is flipped, you cannot think clearly. We need you to calm down before we can even talk about the problem. So one of my absolute favorite coping skills is to play a game. Uno, Trouble, a board game, whatever. Some of you might know, I love Uno. When you come in, I'm like, hey, let's play Uno. It's a great way to calm down, unless I beat you because I'm really good at it. But some kids get surprised when they come in and they're all upset. And I say, you want to play Uno? And they kind of look at me like, sure. But when they're done playing the game, they feel a lot better. And it's because it's a great coping skill. It takes your mind off the issue for a while. And then once we're calmed down, we can talk about it. Maybe we can fix it, find a way to fix it, work through it together. But another great coping skill, play a game.
Now is time you have all been waiting for.
You could be a superhero just like me.
Hi, I'm here with another tip to help you become a super reader. Today I want to talk to you about different types of print within a book. Sometimes when I'm reading a book, I find words that are really, really dark and the letters are thicker. When I'm reading this book, I see several words that have that thick, dark font. What does that mean? Those words are in bold. When I get to a word that's in bold print, I know that the book probably has a glossary, and I'm going to check in the glossary to find out what that word means. Now, some people wait until they get to the end of the book to read the glossary. I don't do that because I want to know what that word means while I'm reading the paragraph about it. So as I read, when I get to this bold word, the very first one, I'm going to flip back to my glossary and find out what that word means. Once I know what the word means, I'll go back and I'm going to reread that whole sentence and see if it makes more sense. If it's really complicated, I might even go back and read the whole paragraph. But I want to make sure that I understand what the paragraph's about. So I'm going to find out the meaning right now instead of waiting until I get to the end of the book to read my glossary. Have a great day. Be a super reader.
We hope that you will continue to come to school on days you were supposed to.
We interrupt WRRS this week for some breaking news. We have our first announcement of the first winner for the Pie in the Face competition, our attendance challenge for intermediate school. So many of you have done a great job participating and were able to vote. And this week's winner is Mr. Sean Gaffney! Woo!
Log into your computer on days you are home and go to your Zoom meetings when you are supposed to. You want to be able to catch one of those mystery votes. Who knows where or when they will pop up. We want pie. This brings an end to our broadcast today. Remember to keep those masks on when you are supposed to. Wash your hands. Do the vampire cough and sneeze, and be respectful of others. Okay, say it with me. We are respectful, we are responsible, we are safe. We are Red Raider Strong.